convocation in Orange County, California. On Friday morning, as I, they call Uberin, right? Is that a word now, Uberin? You take the Uber from the hotel to the airport to fly back here. Normally, when I never listen to radio. When was the last time I turned on the radio? I don't know when. Probably when I was in college. I don't listen to radios, I don't watch TV, because I don't think, and it was worth watching. I was in the car Ubering, so I didn't have a choice. So he had a radio channel on, I don't know what channel that is, who that is, but anyway, the two hosts, one man and one woman on that radio channel, was talking about everything. One of the things they was talking about is the new survey came out about how many percent of the people in the U.S. actually still believe in God or call themselves a Christian. And they was giving us the statistic that in the last 10 years, the number of so-called call themselves Christians have dropped from 79% in the U.S. down to 69.5%. That is almost 10% who used to call themselves as Christians now belong to the group of nuns. And I don't mean N-U-N-S. I don't mean that kind of 10%, the nuns. I mean N-O-N-E-S, the nuns. The surprising thing is that the two hosts was excited was over that news. They think that the way how this country should be going, we should have the freedom to choose, and we don't need to believe in God. That brings me to today, the end of the gospel today. When the Son of Man comes, will he find faith on earth? Do you know most of these today's reading, all the readings, they actually talk about prayers, the importance of prayer, to open up the gospel. I already gave you a homily on how to pray. And for those who's new, it's the APU of praying. Remember that? I gave the homily on the readings when Abraham was the greatest used car negotiator, when he negotiated with God. Remember that? And I said the APU, the A stand for aggressive. The P stand for persistent. And the U stand for unreasonable. What that, you know? And people say, why can't I do that? Hey, but you with God, you don't have to be reasonable. Remember, when was your little kids reasonable with you? And for those who are grandparents, they really aren't reasonable. When the parent asks you to take care of them for a day or two, or half of a night tell you can't do that, you can't do that, you do everything they tell you you can't. So I'm not going to repeat my homily. But today I want to look at a different angle. Every time Jesus heals somebody in the Bible, he always say, your faith have saved you. Or you have received what you ask, go because of your faith. Faith is important in the process of prayer. That's why today we pray, it's not about asking for favor, and I'm going to go back to that. When Jesus talked about the importance of prayer, and he ends the talks on about matter of faith. Faith, my dear beloved, is not have a checklist of I wonders, and then you bring to God as a long list. I used to have that list too. If you go back to last week, homily or reading, sending up you this morning, I asked the children and second grader, tell me about last week reading, about Jesus healing the 10 lepers, and one of them come back and give thanks. My dear beloved, that is prayer. Prayer is to give thanks to God. When the apostle asked Jesus to teach them how to pray, the Lord gave them the prayer. And you look at the first part of the Lord's Prayer, it has nothing about asking, it's about praise and thanksgiving. And then we ask, but give us this day our daily bread. brat. We like to have 3 years. So prayer is not about favor, and it's not about what we want now. No doubt, you and I, we want a lot. When we was young, we lived with our parents. When then we moved into the little one-room apartment, and then we saved money and buy a two-room, three-room house, and then we moved to five-room, and then as we go back to the one-room as we die now. And when you and I really die, we actually only need three by six, is that what it is? Whatever that is, that little room. But we love the thing that we want, no doubt about that. Mother Teresa is well known for that. When she had the prayer, I don't remember everything, but she said, when I ask for patience, and God gave me troubled people so I can learn how to be patient with them. You know, that's that. When you ask for a good priest, God gave me so that you can be good, you know, things like that. When I ask for wisdom, God gave me problems so I can learn how to solve. And at the end of that, Mother Teresa said, well, I received nothing I wanted, but I received everything I needed. And St. Augustine tell us that when God hold off giving us something because he desire our heart to be open more wide. You know, you yearn for that way. So my dear beloved, prayer is thanksgiving. It's not easy to do that. Not easy to ask. If you look, you read the gospel reading today, this honest judge, he is honest. But the woman, he didn't do the woman any favor. The woman was asked him to grant a justly decision, not a favor. And finally, he granted her that right decision. She didn't come and ask him for favor. So prayer is about that, about doing the right thing, not asking for favor. But we human, we love that all the time. I love it, you love it. We all want extra. I just couldn't wait to get back here, the property with the buildings, you know, the house where they ran, I rented now. Since the hurricane last year, the roof is kind of missing pieces. So I did call the owner and said that they need to do something. So on Friday, they came and they put a big, torch over that, tied down the rope. Thanks be to God. Last night, the whole night. You know how many times they had to win? Remember last night they had to win? I say sucks. Four of them, almost quarter to four. I actually get in my car, drove out into the field, you know, my area, I sleep in the car. Because I couldn't handle the whole night. But you know what? I complain and I'm angry. That's why I couldn't sleep. Every time I hear, I was about to come out with the rope. But I worried that when I cut the rope, then I'm going to have to clean the house with the water coming in and dropping all those things. But when I get to the car, I'm still angry. I'm still angry. But as I laid in that car, I recall one of the man who did the late night shift with us, the tall guy, the grand man, Doug Klusky. Because I said, well, we still have a lot of wood left, you know. And he said, well, somebody going to be taken to somebody. Because, you know, he meant me, because, you know, in the winter, I take them to the homeless. As that thought came to my mind, I said, hey, Martino, shut your mouth. Unless you have a car to get in. Many people don't under this way. Then I shut my mouth, I stop complaining, I stop getting angry, and I begin to give thanks, and then I could fall asleep. And then the alarm came up at 7:10. But I want to share with you. That's why I talked about last week. Every time I tell you, I never prepare a homily for you. I said that all over. You might not believe it, but why do I know that? What read it in the homily? Because every week I prepare a homily for myself. I share with you these things. Yeah, it's funny, but it's the reality. So you know I'm struggling with the needs and the wants just like you, from the little thing to the big things. I don't know. Maybe all the priests are holy. I am not. I don't know, but sometimes I wonder how terrible I am, how human I am. But you know that my own struggle. Even last night, you know, I just grind my teeth and get angry. And then I come to realize that means Thanksgiving, to connect with God, to have that personal relationship, to give thanks to Him in all times, in good times and in bad times, in sickness and in health. And it's not easy. I struggle with that every day. My last struggle was last night, early this morning. So, talking about prayer and faith, I'd like to promote one thing about the daily mass. I'd like to invite you to, if possible, try to make once a month kind of daily mass or holy hour. Recently, I talked to a few retiring people and invited to go to Mass, and I realized that some of them can't make to the 8:30 Mass because of their health. In order to go to the 8:30 Mass, they have to say, they have to wake up about 4 or 4:30 in the morning. They have to stress. They have to put their feet in the warm water for at least an hour before they can balance themselves. You know, when hearing those things, it humbles me. And it's met with the things that I need to do them. So beginning with November, which that's when I will give the homily for that whole month. But I will move the Tuesday morning mass to the noon mass. So Tuesday, the mass will be at noon. So certain people could come. I understand it works for some, but we try to provide an opportunity so all can do. That's why I moved the Friday Mass to Friday evening, because certain people could come and a few families have come on and off on Fridays. So I'd like to invite you to make that personal connection with God. There's no better way to give and thanks than in the Mass. You personally meet Him and thanks Him, and eating the meal with Him. So I like to promote that one. You know what? When the Son of Man comes, will He find faith on earth? I don't have an answer for that. And I don't think I'm responsible for that. Be honest with you, I'm not the Pope. Not this job. I'm just a lowly pastor in a church that nobody wants to be the pastor. It used to be nobody wanted. Now everybody wants it. Now every priest wants to go here. It used to be no one wants it. I am just the pastor here, but I can surely look God in the eyes, look my eye to them. I say, God, I don't know if there will be faith on earth, but I guarantee you there will be faith here in after I'm coming. Amen? Do you know why I can guarantee that to God? Because just like the first reading, when Moses was praying and he was so tired, he couldn't even hold his hands up. Aaron on one side and the other one said, have to help Jesus to hold his hands up. I know there will be faith here in Effingham County because that's what we do right here in the church family. One person is tired, we lift that person up. We help them. We walk with them. We encourage them and we support them. So Lord, to answer your question, when the Son of Man comes, will we find faith here in Effingham? I say yes. You will find us here waiting for you, though struggle, though sinful, but faithful to your word and your teaching, because that's how we get to heaven. And until then, may what we do give the glory to God. Amen.